there have been reports on the eastern side. Please check. Yes, sir. On that way now. Thank you. Thank you. Roger. In the case of an attack, please shoot on sight.
Yes, General Lafayette. What is it that you're calling for? We're under attack. Bring me the missile system.
Ma'am, Command Ops is wondering, what is your order?
Launch them.
The attack was a success, ma'am.
Excellent. The British are going to have to surrender soon. They have limited resources and just lost a key battle.
Sir, the Queen of England is demanding to speak to you. No, she's here in person.
Send her in.
What the heck is going on?
What are you talking about? What do you want me to do? The French have overpowered us. They're better than us in the military sense.
Inspire them. You need to give them a speech.
A speech? A speech? When do you want me to give them a speech? Tomorrow?
Yes, tomorrow.
But tomorrow's St. Crispin's Day.
Exactly. That's when you need to do it. Your job is on the line. Get it done.
I will.
Get it done.
My fellow Englishmen, what wishes that he so? My cousin Westmoreland, know my fair cousin. If we are marked to die, we are now. To do our country loss, and if to live, the fewer men, the greater share of honor. God's will, I pray thee, wish not one man more. By Jove, I am not covetous for gold, nor care I who doth feed upon my cost. It yearns me not if men my garments wear, such outward things dwell not in my desires. But if it be a sin to covet honor, I am the most offending soul alive. No, faith, my cuz, wish not a man from England. God's peace, I would not lose so great an honor, as one man more, methinks, would share from me for the best hope I have. Oh, do not wish one more, rather proclaim it, Westmoreland, through my host, that he which hath no stomach to this fight, let him depart. His passport shall be made, and crowds for convoy put into his purse. We would not die for that man's company, that fears his fellowship to die within us. This day is called the Feast of Crispian. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand a tiptoe when the day is named and rouse him at the name of Crispian. That shall live this day and see old age will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say tomorrow is Saint Crispian. Then will he strip his sleeve and show the scars and say these wounds I had on Crispian's day. Old men forget, yet all shall be forgotten. But he'll remember with advantages what feasts he did that day. Then shall our names.
Familiar in his mouth is household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester, be in their flowing cups freshly remembered. This story shall the good man teach his son, and Crispin Crispian shall never go by, from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers, for he today that sheds his blood with me, shall be my brother, be never so vile. This day shall gentle his condition, and gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves accused they were not here, and hold it their manhoods cheap whiles any speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
That's right. The war between England and France is over. President Adelaide of France, along with Rhys and the Queen, are signing the treaty to end the war officially as we speak.
Thank you for your understanding, President Adelaide.
I'm glad we could come to an agreement.
All right, good job with your speech. We won the war and England's at peace now.
Thank you, Queen. Would you mind giving me a moment?
Yes.
Well done.
Yes, Madam Parliament Speaker. Of course I understand that as President of Germany, it should be kept a secret that we are cooperating to ruin Rhys's career as Prime Minister. One more thing. Rhys may think the war is over, but as far as I'm concerned, the war has just begun.
My line!
Improvise!